Welcome to the fourth day here at Bauma. I'm reporting from the atrium, the heart of the Liebherr booth. This shows once again how versatile the group is. Liebherr has long been at the forefront not only in construction machines, but also in areas such as aerospace. The family-run company has been active in a wide range of industries for over 75 years and continues to set new standards. And it is precisely this diversity that we take a closer look at, with a look at very different products. On the one hand, there is the T264 mining truck from the mining sector. In addition, the intelligent weighing system and the bucket fill assist from Earthmoving. And finally, the LRB19, a real powerhouse from Deep Foundation. We already presented the so-called bucket fill assist on the larger excavators at the last Bauma, on the crawler excavators over 60 tons. And this time we have it on the entire Generation 8. So from 22 tons upwards, there is this bucket fill assist, the BFA. The bucket fill assist fills the bucket automatically. A system that allows the entire system to be opened and closed with practically a single hand movement. Bucket filling cycle and thus achieves an almost 100% bucket filling level. The new feature this time, compared to the last Bauma, is the weighing system. This means that we now have a system in which we can dynamically weigh how much material is in my bucket during the bucket filling process. And of course, that's interesting when I'm loading lorries. Lorries have a maximum load limit. And now I can see cumulatively how many cycles I have done, how many are still missing until the lorry is optimally loaded. And so I can load my lorries perfectly. So here behind us is the LRB19, the newest member of the LRB family. This was presented here at Bauma. In other words, a world first, a truly revolutionary machine in this field for specialized civil engineering applications. We have endeavored to combine two systems of leader options, telescopic and steel leader. Both gain advantages from it. We have implemented that here, with a new hose guide and docking station. A special feature of the machine is its light transport weight of 40 tons without attachments, or 53 tons complete, which is unique in this class.
This is our Liebherr T264 battery electric autonomous truck, powered by a Fortescue 0 battery power module system. This truck has some great new technologies we'd like to are displaying here at the Bauma trade show, and it first starts off with the Liebherr power rail as a method for dynamic charging of the truck. So what this truck does, it provides both power and energy for the truck while in motion through a rail connected to the side of the truck. Next, on the off-driver side, we're displaying our static charging solution, which is able to achieve up to 6 megawatts of power through 2 MCS connectors, and all connections are made through an automatic robotic connection arm. The final way to charge this truck is through regenerative braking. So while the truck is driving downhill roads, whether loaded or empty, they're able to collect that energy on board the battery power system.
Now it's getting serious for me. Now it's hands-on again. I get to drive a crawler dozer in the innovation lab, all with the support of technology, LiReCon and Florian Falbesoner. Nice to see you, Florian. This is my workplace. This is your workplace. Thank you very much. Please take a seat. Let's get started. What is LiReCon all about? LiReCon is our cross-divisional development. This means that we have a control center for the earth-moving machines, for the tower cranes, but also for the offshore machines. We thus offer our customers the option of switching between a wide variety of machines, from an excavator to a tower crane or on a crawler dozer to TELFs. Show me how to control it. To start, simply release the parking brake. I'll do it now. Yes, please. You control the machine with your left hand and the panel with your right. Just drive straight ahead. Keep going forward. A little more. Simply drive forwards. Data is transmitted via the internet, and you can't tell the difference that we are 100 kilometers away.
Wow, Florian,
what an experience. Thank you very much. And even in customer service, proximity is no longer a question of location. Markus Wittrock from the Wittrock Group and his employees use Liebherr's customer service. Let's take a look at that now. So we are two corporate groups. One is the Wittrock Group, which includes the company Hermann and Wittrock and Tichkers and Wittrock, and the second group is the company Olfertz and Wittrock. My father founded the company in 1970, and we have been a Liebherr customer ever since. We are actually in regular contact with Liebherr. It's not just the crane purchase, but also life afterwards, i.e. customer service. We have our own sites with our own workshops. They have a very close connection to customer service and sort things out there. But we also have smaller sites, so there aren't as many workshop staff on site. Customer service then often comes out to us. If we have a problem or a challenge, we call and talk about it. If we simply need parts, we order them via my Liebherr. It's quick and easy for us, it's no problem at all. You can see the catalogs and documents immediately. If we don't make any progress, they'll send someone out, and this is usually relatively quick and unproblematic. Turning old into new, this principle also exists at Liebherr and is called Reman, short for remanufacturing. I am now standing here with Nina Wolf in front of such an engine, which reflects precisely this principle. Nina, what is the idea behind it?
The engine we see here is being reconditioned from an old condition to as new condition.
Now you can find out what it all looks like in detail.
At Liebherr, we recondition components such as diesel engines, gas engines, hydraulic pumps and hydraulic motors, as well as gearboxes including travel drives, swiveling drives, distribution gear units and rope winches. And of course, a wide range of individual parts such as turbochargers and injection pumps. The old goods are delivered to us, we pre-clean the components, then we dismantle them into their individual parts, analyze them, and then we decide whether there are good or bad parts. The good parts are also reconditioned if necessary. The component is then assembled, tested, painted, and delivered again. In contrast to recycling and repair, remanufacturing involves reconditioning. This means that we recondition old parts to as new condition. We once analyzed an engine to see how much you actually save. And due to the reject rates and the transport effects, it turned out that we save 50% CO2 by using Reman. Due to the Reman program, customers benefit from lower purchase prices compared to new parts and the goods are available directly from our central warehouse. Another important point is the long-term supply of spare parts. We at Liebherr are always thinking one step ahead and want to expand our Reman program. This means that we want to include more engines in our portfolio and recondition more individual parts.
This was episode 4 of our Liebherr video magazine from Bauma 2025. We are now standing here at the Liebherr training booth, where everything revolves around the skilled workers of tomorrow. Whether it's an apprenticeship or a dual study program, young talents can start their career path here and experience firsthand what Liebherr is all about as an employer. But what comes next? Tomorrow, we will take a look at the career opportunities for experienced professionals. What happens after the apprenticeship? What opportunities does Liebherr offer for professionals in the construction industry? Stay tuned, it's worth it.